मैं इससे फुल स्क्रीन कर देता था, यहाँ जो आता था ना
भाई।
यहीं से फुल स्क्रीन होता था, तो मुझे पता नहीं चल जाता यार अदर साइड में जा रहा है कि नहीं जा रहा।
डोंट वरी, नाउ योर लाइफ, सो सून यू विल सी पीपल स्टार्ट जॉइनिंग, बट व्हेन इट इज लाइव योर वॉइस हैज स्टार्टेड गोइंग, सो व्हाटएवर आई एम टॉकिंग टू यू इट इज आल्सो गोइंग देयर।
लर्नर्स जयन,
जैसे इट विल क्लास 1500 यू कैन स्टार्ट द सेशन।
ओके ओके,
so first time you just wait to change the screen, once the screen change then you keep on, it will go with its own speed. Okay, theek hai,
abhi screen change hoga control t karne ke baad. Hello friends, we'll start this session within a couple of minutes. Let us wait. Now around 600-700 learners have already joined. We'll wait for a couple of minutes. व्याकरण इसमें आता है हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई निराधर देव, फैकल्टी मेंबर, स्कूल ऑफ एजुकेशन, इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी. ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ स्कूल ऑफ एजुकेशन इग्नू एंड ऑन माय पर्सनल बिहाफ, आई वेलकम ऑल आवर लर्नर्स, ऑल आवर बीएड सेकेंड ईयर लर्नर्स टू दिस ऑनलाइन वर्कशॉप, सेकेंड ईयर वर्कशॉप. इन द फर्स्ट सेशन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड फाइव असेसमेंट. What is the importance and concept of assessment? And particularly, we have discussed about the constructivist perspective, the constructivist concept, context, and the constructivist approach of teaching learning process and assessment. We have also discussed about assessment of learning, the concept of assessment of learning, and the concept of assessment for learning. Friends, when we are discussing the concept of assessment for learning, we have discussed about that multiple techniques, multiple tools that can be used in the process of assessment. Because so far as student dynamism is concerned, so far as diversity is concerned, so far as classroom structure is concerned, you will find that the students to whom, as a teacher, to whom we are dealing, they are coming from different background. They are coming from different socio-economic background. They are coming from a different language background. So far as their scholastic abilities is concerned, and so far as their other abilities is concerned, their family, their community, the society in which they are living, you will find that many diversities is there. So when there are many diversities within the individual in their mental abilities, in their attitude, in their interest, in their aptitude, in their intelligence, at the same time with their socio-economic background. So it is quite obvious that it's not possible to implement a single or few techniques of assessment, few methods or few tools of assessment to know the performance of the learner. Okay, so that's why many techniques, multiple techniques can be used contextually. So we have to, as a teacher, we have to find out that which tool is perfectly fit for knowing the assessment, for knowing the performance of the learners to a particular content. And that is also in a particular subject. So accordingly, we have to select and we have to apply. And many a time, to a particular content also, to a particular topic also, more than one tools, multiple tools can also be used. You will find in your class many students, they might be differently able. Okay, jisko hum kehte hain divyang. So how to deal that group of students also? Okay, so for them, a single technique, single strategy and method, tool and test is not perfectly fit. So that's why what we can do, we can use many techniques, we can use many methods. So in this session, dedicatedly, we have kept to discuss about how to assess. First, we have discussed why assessment, the concept and principle, the context and perspective of assessment we have discussed. And in this session, we'll discuss that what are the tools, what are the techniques that can be used in assessment. Okay. And this has been taken, as already I have said in my first session, this has been taken from the second year compulsory course, core course, that is BES 1-7, assessment for learning. So friends, let us proceed to understand this concept that how to assess. You see, yes, the learning outcome of today's session, that is to explain the type of tools used for assessment of scholastic and post-scholastic areas or abilities of the learners, that what are the types of tools we'll use to assess the scholastic abilities of the learners, and what are the tools that can be used for assessing the post-scholastic abilities of the learners. Then further to share the feedback on the tools you have developed during your internship. You see, friends, the workshop handbook that you have received, already we have given a detailed schedule of the second year workshop, and there how to conduct different sessions of the second year workshop. Here we have mentioned that what you have to do during this workshop, you should come forward with the tools that you have developed during your internship. So that's why this is also one of the learning outcome, that the tools that you have developed during your internship, they are supposed to discuss, and you have to take the feedback during this workshop period. Then further, to prepare a blueprint of an assessment tool, you have to prepare a blueprint. We will discuss further that what is the concept of a blueprint that has been discussed in this course, and again I will discuss that what is the concept of a blueprint, what are the different dimensions for preparing the blueprint. Then accordingly, the last learning outcome of this session, that is to develop a tool as per the blueprint for assessing scholastic, post-scholastic areas of students' performance or abilities individually or in a small group. So friends, try to understand, you have to develop a blueprint, then accordingly, as per the blueprint, you have to develop a tool, and that tool you are supposed to submit at your study center today's afternoon session, and you have to develop and submit that tool, and discussion will be taken on that tool in the second at the afternoon at your study center. So that will be the activity. So these are the four different learning outcomes of today's session, and the resources which required for conducting this session, this has already mentioned, and this is expected that you are attending your workshop. You must have such resources with you, because it will help you to understand, and you must have come out with certain, you can say pre-learning, come out with certain reading of these units that has been mentioned, that is unit 5 and 7 of block 2 and unit 9 and 10 of block 3. That is from the course BES 1-7 assessment for learning. Okay, so for this session has been taken from four different units. You will find the concept that has been discussed here. It may be tools, it may be techniques, it may be test, it may be blueprint, and how to prepare a tool, how to prepare an achievement test. So four units, you will find that it covers four different units of the course BES 1-7, that is unit 5, unit 7, unit 9 and unit 10. Then further, the resources which is required, that is secondary level textbooks on subject of your choice, that is you can take the subjects that you are teaching, you can take that textbook maybe from class 9th or 10th, from any subject, maybe language, maybe science, maybe social science, maybe mathematics. So these are the resources required for doing the activities of this session. You see, as I was talking earlier, that we use for assessing the title of the topic is how to assess for assessing performance of the learners, abilities of the learners, maybe from their scholastic areas or maybe from their post-scholastic areas. We use certain tests and we use certain tools. So, friends, let us try to understand when we talk about test. Tests are usually used to assess the scholastic abilities of the students, such as achievement. We say that achievement test, aptitude test, intelligence test, the creativity test, accordingly personality also. So when we talk about test, it focuses upon the achievement, means to knowing the progress of the learners, to knowing the, the level of progress of the learner, to knowing the performance of the learners. We develop certain achievement tests and we implement, we administer that achievement test upon that group of learners. So friends, when we talk about the test, it may be achievement, aptitude, intelligence or creativity. And further, when we talk about tools are usually used to assess the core scholastic abilities of the students. We use the test for assessing the scholastic abilities. Okay. Scholastic abilities, which is related to the teaching learning process, that is covers across the subjects. Okay. Means your achievement in languages, your achievement in science, your achievement in social science, your achievement in mathematics, mostly the subject areas. And the other areas that we call, that's called as the post-scholastic abilities. So friends, as per NCRT, as per NCF 2005, National Curriculum Framework 2005, we consider that every activities that being conducted in the school, okay, may be related to subject or may be related to personality, attitude and other aspects of student development, all are the scholastic abilities, okay, which is not related to the subject, but we are saying that it is not, it is the other activities, but exactly that is not the other activities. That is also related to the development, the scholastic development of the learners. But we are using this post-scholastic, the term post-scholastic, but that is really related, that is really the scholastic abilities of the learners. But here, the tools that we have discussed in this session, that is usually used to assess the post-scholastic abilities of the students, such as leadership quality of the students, life skills of the students, interpersonal relationships of the students, communication skill of the students, attitude of the students, self-concept of the students, and other types of students' development also. Okay. So, friends, be clear that tests are mostly used for assessing the scholastic abilities and tools are mostly used for assessing the post-scholastic abilities. And post-scholastic abilities are the part of scholastic abilities. Post-scholastic abilities helps to achieve the scholastic abilities. So that's why you shouldn't get any confusion that what is the test and what is the tool. Okay. So in a school system, we use multiple tools, we use multiple tests. So far as the context, so far as the purpose is concerned, that what really we want to assess. Okay, so accordingly, we have to select the strategy. Accordingly, we have to select the test, the particular test. And accordingly, we have to select the particular tool. So friends, let us come forward. Here you see, when to discuss test versus tools, we can say, just I had taken few tests, the name of few tests and the name of few tools, you can also add on it. Just like under test, here the paper pencil test that we use in our school system, in our examination, it may be continuous assessment, it may be term and examination also. Then we use oral test, we use aptitude test, we use achievement test, we use diagnostic remedial test, and we use intelligent test and other types of tests that we also use. In this session, our focus is on to discuss these six types of tests, that is paper pencil test, oral test, aptitude test, achievement test, diagnostic remedial test, and intelligent test. And further, under tools, in this session, we will discuss about the rating scale, how to use the rating scale, and for what purpose for what purpose we use the writing skill. Then we'll also discuss about the use of questionnaire, how to develop the questionnaire, then inventories, what is the concept of inventories, then checklist, where to use the checklist, what is the concept of a checklist, then interview schedule, where to use the interview schedule, where to use the observation. As I have already said that, so far as constructivist approach of teaching and learning process is concerned, constructivist approach of class is concerned, here teacher observation is given much more importance in comparison to other types of tools, because teacher is the most pertinent part of the teaching learning process, that every day teacher observes the behavior of the students. Okay, when the students are doing something within the peers, within the groups, okay, presenting something, exhibiting something, participating in any activities, so that is being conducted with the supervision of the teacher. So that's why teacher observation takes a very, very important part in the teaching learning process so far as assessment is concerned. So that's why observation, how to develop, what is the concept of observation, we'll also discuss in this session. Then further we'll discuss about the anecdotal record. What is that anecdotal record? Okay. What is that cumulative anecdotal record? That also we'll discuss. Then portfolio and rubrics. So presently you will find that most of the schools are also using portfolio and rubrics. So what is the concept of a portfolio and how to implement portfolio or rubrics as an assessment tool? That also we'll discuss. Because friends, you see, whatever things, whatever the point, the test and tools I am explaining here, further you have to do it practically in your activity. You have to develop a tool at the end of the session, at the afternoon in your study center, either individually or in a group. So that's why you have to better understand that what type of tool you have to develop for your activity, because on the basis of that activity, your session will be evaluated. You will get certain grade, and all the grades of different session will be accumulated, and you will get a final grade of your workshop. So that's why be particular about to understand the test, different test and different tools. Friends, let us go forward. Then first we'll start our discussion on different types of test. Let us focus upon paper pencil test. You see, paper pencil test means mostly the multiple choice type of test that we conduct, that's called as the MCQ, multiple choice type of questions. Okay, so that we can use, to know the intelligence, to know the achievement of the learners, attitude or subject wise criterion test also. Okay, so we can develop a criterion test on the basis or from across the subject, let to know the performance, to know the level of mastery of the students in history in a particular class, in class 9th or in class 10th or in class 8th. Okay, so here we'll fix certain criteria, then after we have to develop a test. So by using the paper pencil test, we can assess the attitude, achievement, intelligence, and we can develop many subject-wise criterion tests also. Further, let us try to understand that what is a oral test. You see, the term that has been used, that is oral. Oral means the learner will say something verbally, explain something, describe something, narrate something. Okay, tell a story. Tell an anecdote. Okay, so here the learners, what they will do, they will explain, they will say about an anecdote, about an event, about a situation. Okay, so this has been kept because to provide learner a type of, you can say, type of environment where freely they will come out and say something, they expose themselves, they can involve themselves in the process of interacting with the teacher. So without an active interaction, without expressing themselves, then you cannot find out that what the learners really thinks, what the learner really want to say. So that's why oral test is many a time you will find that it is very much important. So oral tests are used to provide oral response to answer the question. Okay, so this is not a paper pencil test that you have to one question is there, then four option is there. So what you have to do, either by using a dot pen or by using a pencil, you are just making it round or making it tick to a particular option. Under every question, four options are given. But here in oral test, you will find that subjectively, descriptively, narratively, the students are involved themselves for providing the response. Okay, so that's why it is one of the important aspects so far as the language skill is concerned. Many a time you will find that oral test is particularly important in language classes, because spoken language plays an important role to express oneself. You just, if you are a language teacher, you ask yourself that when you are teaching maybe English literature or maybe any regional languages, mother tongue, any regional language, so what you are doing? What you are doing? You are just model reading. You are just doing the model reading, and you are asking the learners that at least they read a paragraph, read at least they recite a poem, because you want to know their pronunciation, you want to know their speaking abilities, you want to know whether their pronunciation is perfect or not so far as different word is concerned, whether they are taking perfect pause or not, because where to take what type of pause, there is a full stop, there is a comma, so how much pause is required. And you'll find that when the students are reading or giving oral response, whether the sentences that the students are using, whether it is connected or not. So that's why particularly in language classes we use oral test. Okay, so oral test is much more important in comparison to other types of tests so far as the language teaching is concerned. Then further, it focuses on students' ability to communicate with what they know and how they articulate the things. So many a time you will find that if you not involve the students in the process of communication, in the process of interaction, if you not involve students in oral test, you cannot find that what they really know. वो क्या जानते हैं, ओके, और वो एक्सप्रेस कर पाते हैं या नहीं, और वो एटिकुलेट करके ठीक से उसे बोल पाते हैं या नहीं, वेदर एक बातों के साथ दूसरे बातें फर्स्ट सेंटेंस के साथ सेकंड सेंटेंस कनेक्शन मेंटेन कर पाता है या नहीं. सो दैट्स व्हाई कीपिंग इन कंसिडरेशन ऑफ ऑल सच थिंग्स मेनी अ टाइम वी ऑल्सो यूज ओरल टेस्ट इन द क्लास वन टू वन एंड ग्रुप ओरल टेस्ट ऑल्सो वी कैन टेक. Many a time what we are doing a group discussion. Okay, so orally, let you have put forward with a question, with an issue, with an idea, and you are inviting learners to come forward and express their views, express their opinions. So many a time it may be conducted in a group or it may be conducted individually, also means teacher and the students. So oral test can be used so far as language and literature is concerned. And this can also be used in other aspect also for narrating the things, for describing different, you can say, science-related ideas, science-related issues, environment-related issues, okay, social issues also. Many a time you can engage students to say something about social issues that they have observed, that they have faced, that every day they are practicing, okay, they are observing from their immediate society, that they are observing from their family. Okay, so that also you can do. But mostly this can be done in language classes. Further, we'll come to aptitude test. Friends, many a time you'll find that aptitude, achievement, and intelligence, we get confused. Okay, because you'll find that the items that you'll write in aptitude test somehow more or less related with the achievement. You just remember, go back to your B.Ed entrance test. Many a time you will find that B.Ed entrance test is a teaching aptitude test. Okay, the items that has been kept in different subject areas, okay, you will find that certain item is also related to achievement, but that achievement is not related to your B.Ed program. That achievement, or you can say that that question is related to your prior experiences and prior knowledge, which is required to pursue, which is required to, you can say, undergo the BEd program. So that's why the though items are more or less related with intelligence, related with achievement, but specifically you can develop aptitude test, achievement test, and intelligence test. Here you see aptitude tests are used to determine and measure an individual's ability and skills to acquire through future training or future performances, okay, future occurrences. Means the aptitude test that you will develop, that test will develop for future use, okay, just like your entrance examination test. So that is for future use. Yes, on the basis of that test, what we have done, on the basis of that test, we have given placement to the learners, but further, that placement is not enough. After getting the placement, what the learners will do? They have to pursue this program, okay? Yes, they have shown their aptitude, they have the aptitude, they have the teaching aptitude. Further, they have to prove their teaching aptitude in the BEd program. When they successfully complete all their theory courses with good performance, at the same time when they will able to complete all their practical abilities, okay? Maybe internship, maybe your practice teaching, maybe your final teaching, at the same time, maybe your workshop and other types of activities that has been kept in your BEd program. So if a learner who has done well in the aptitude test, in the teaching aptitude test, but not able to perform well in the BEd program, then here there is a question. We may ask ourselves, the aptitude test that we have developed, that may be some problem. Because my aptitude test had not that power, had not that that ability to select a good students who has really, really having the teaching aptitude, because they are not doing well in the BEd program. So that's why if I will talk about aptitude test, it takes hours together. We have to proceed forward because many things we have to cover in this session. Then further, aptitude tests are used to predict future performance of the learners. Then examples of aptitude tests can be said just like teaching aptitude, engineering aptitude, just like the NEET exam, which is conducted by CBSE and now it is conducted by National Testing Agency. So what they're doing, they're just selecting a group of candidates. Those are having engineering abilities to pursue or to take admission in the IITs, to take admission in the NITs, at the same time other engineering programs across this country. And further you can say the medical aptitude also, medical aptitude in NEET, those are taking the medical branch. You will find that through that test, that is a medical aptitude test, through that test, a group of learners, a group of candidates are being selected for pursuing the medical program, pursuing the MBBS in different medical institute. Okay, so that's why medical aptitude, musical aptitude, that is also an aptitude test, whether the candidate is having musical aptitude or not. Then aptitude in sports, all are not having the aptitude towards sports. So we can also assess, we can also find out by using an aptitude test, whether aptitude in sports or aptitude in music is there or not. So friends, the focus of aptitude test is not for present. Okay, keeping in consideration of the present ability, we get an idea that how the candidate will do well in future, because that is for future use purposes. That is for providing placement to the learners to do well in future. Further, let us come to discuss about the achievement test. You see, achievement test is very, very important for the part of the teacher because achievement test is highly used in the school process. Okay, so here today, what you have to do, you have to prepare, you have to develop an achievement test. I'm not saying that you develop other tool, you can develop other tool, but as per the blueprint, if you prepare an achievement test, then I think this session will be a fruitful session. So here you see, it is used to measure the learning outcomes of the students in various subjects. So learning outcomes of the students in various subjects. So we have a curriculum. So our intention is to implement that curriculum. So with the curriculum, we have certain learning outcomes. So how to assess, how to measure the learning outcomes? So we have to develop an achievement test. Okay. So I will discuss that, how to develop an achievement test. Further, it is used to know learning progress and difficulties of the students. Friends, do remember, in my past session, when to discuss about types of assessment, types of evaluation, I had given example, placement, formative, diagnostic, and summative evaluation. Here you see, it is used to know, achievement test is used to know learning progress and difficulties of the students. Whether the learners are getting mastery or not, whether the learners are progressing or not, what are the learning difficulties they are facing, and whether the learning difficulties are identified or not by conducting the diagnostic test. And after identifying the learning difficulties, whether remedial instruction is given to the students or not. This is also part of the achievement test. Then further, on the basis of achievement test, individual instructions are given. I have already said that what you have to do, you have to find out the learning progress. As a teacher, you should know the learning progress of the learners. Okay. So after knowing the learning progress, if you are getting that a group of learners, group of students in your class is not performing well, then you have to identify that group of learners. You have to find out by doing the diagnostic test, you have to find out what are the causes. Then accordingly, you have to give the remediation. Okay, so that's why that remediation can be given in group. That remediation can also be given individual also. So that's why you have to always keep in your mind that the instruction, the remedial instruction is most when there is the learning difficulties. When the learning difficulties are identified within the students, then achievement test is used to know effectiveness of any academic program. So friends, you see, we have implemented this BEd program. We have implemented different core courses, different elective courses, different pedagogy courses of this BEd program. How to know whether these courses are effective courses or not? By conducting a type of achievement test, we can find out, yes, this is an effective program. And we have the BEd program keeping in consideration of your performance. You are our product, that what you will do in future, what output you will get, what knowledge base, what skills that you will acquire from this program. So that is the product. So here you see, the effectiveness of any program can also be assessed, can also be measured through achievement test. It is very much famous in assessment of school related activities, practices that I have already said. You all, every day you are doing any different types of achievement test. So that's why you are very much acquainted with the achievement test, and I'm sure that definitely you have to develop an achievement test. We can take the example that is subject-related achievement test of the students. Achievement in mathematics, achievement in science, achievement in social science, achievement in languages, different languages, okay, that you are doing. Then further, the another test that we'll discuss in this session, that is the diagnostic remedial test. I have already given the impression in the past session that's called as the diagnostic remedial formative assessment and diagnostic assessment. When we talk about diagnostic assessment, so that can be done a diagnostic remedial test. Okay. So achievement tests are used to identify the strengths and weaknesses of the students. And you see, when there is the weaknesses, then further what you have to do, that weaknesses should be identified and accordingly treatment should be given. Its purpose is to identify learning difficulties of the students and to provide remedial measures. So you have to provide remedial measure. Only knowing the learning difficulties, knowing the causes is not enough. Okay. So what you have to do, you implement a diagnostic test, you identified the learning difficulties, then you left the students. Okay. Unke haal mein unko chhod diya. तो आपका पर्पस सर्व नहीं हुआ। आपका पर्पस तभी सर्व होगा जब लर्निंग डिफिकल्टीज को आप आइडेंटिफाई करेंगे, और लर्निंग डिफिकल्टीज को आइडेंटिफाई करने के बाद रिमेडियल इंस्ट्रक्शन उनको आप देंगे। ओके, यू हैव टू मेक एन एक्शन प्लान, यू हैव टू डेवलप, यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर ए स्ट्रेटेजी हाउ टू डील दैट ग्रुप ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स। ओके, बाय प्रोवाइडिंग इंस्ट्रक्शनल इंडिविजुअल इंस्ट्रक्शन और ग्रुप इंस्ट्रक्शन, एंड फर्दर व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व देयर प्रोग्रेस ऑल्सो ओवर द टाइम। After 1 month, after 15 days, after giving certain remedial instruction, whether they are coming equitable with other learners or not, whether they are coming at an average standard or not, whether they are coming with the standard of other students or not, that you have to observe. And if again they are not coming to that standard, then you have to change your approach. Okay, you have to change your strategy. So friends, when I talk about diagnostic remedial test, you have to identify the learning difficulties, provide the treatment, provide the instruction, individual instruction. Then after few days, after a gap of time period, then you have to observe whether the purpose has been served or not. Then it can be used across the subject. I have already said it can be specifically used if the teachers identified learning difficulties among the students. So many a time, you must have observed such thing in your class. Let me to say, this is my experience, that many a time you will find that school identified few students and few students are attached with a teacher. Okay, हम कहते हैं इन students को हम गोद में लिए हैं। इसका मतलब क्या है? इसका मतलब है कि उन student का जो development नहीं हो रहा है particular subject में, मुझे कुछ एक्स्ट्रा एज ए टीचर मुझे कुछ एक्स्ट्रा केयर देना पड़ेगा, एक्स्ट्रा केयर देकर मुझे उनको एक लेवल तक लाना है। इन माय बीइंग ए टीचर, आई एम ए स्पिरिटेड टीचर, यू आर ए स्पिरिटेड टीचर, ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई यू आर ए कमिटेड टीचर। तो ये आपका रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी आप फील करेंगे, एक दो स्टूडेंट्स को आप अपने गोद पे लेंगे, लेकर उनका जो समस्या है वो समस्या को आपको हल करेंगे, हल करके एंड दैट शुड बी विजिबल after few months, after few days. That is the success you can say in the process of teaching and learning. Then further, remedial tests are used usually subjective and individual in nature. I have already said that individual remedial instruction can be given, or it can also be given in group. This can also be given in group only in that case when similar types of difficulties, similar types of problem lies with the students. Okay, so be sure of it. Then further, we'll talk about the intelligent test. I think from BES 1 to 3, you must have studied about the intelligent test, the concept of intelligence, the multiple intelligence, the individual intelligence, that already the verbal, what type of test that you can use to measure the intelligence, the concept that already you must have discussed, must have studied. But here, intelligent tests are used to measure the general mental ability of the students, the mental ability of the students. Okay. So for intelligence, for knowing the general mental ability, you will find that items can be taken from different areas, from different components. Okay. It may be from general awareness, maybe from reasoning, maybe from logic, maybe from, you can say, general knowledge, maybe from languages also, maybe from communication. Okay, maybe from certain graphical questions also that can be done. Then it can be individual test or group test. Group intelligent test can be used and individual test can also be used. Then intelligence is defined in terms of mental and chronological age. Try to understand that how to measure, how to know that what level of intelligence a child is having. So that's why two concepts is there. One is called as the mental age and the other is called as the chronological age. So you have to understand that what is the mental age of a child and what is the chronological age of the child for knowing the IQ. That's called as intelligence quotient. Intelligent quotient. Okay, that is the measure. That is the measure of intelligence. You see, mental age is the you can say the ability of the learners, and chronological age is the exact age of the learner. Let a learner is in 9th standard, okay, And as per the growth and development and as per our schooling system, 9th standard is come at the secondary stage. So far as the NEP 2020 is concerned, that it is in the fourth stage, 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4 system of education. Class 9, 10th, 11th, 12th are called as the secondary stage. So in class 9th, you'll find that their age will be, I think, 14. Age will be 14. So here, the chronological age of class 9 student may be 14 or 15. That cannot be changed. Chronological age is the exact age of the child. Okay. That is the biological age of the child. And further, what you have to do, for knowing the IQ, you have to find out the mental age. You see, let biological age or the chronological age is 14 of a child, but you can't say that the mental age will also 14 of their child. Mental age may be above 14 or may be below 14 also. 14 se jyada ho sakta hai aur 14 se kam bhi ho sakta hai. 14 se jyada tab hoga if a 14 age group child is able to solve the problem, do the things which is meant for 15th age group students, which is meant for 16th age group student. Let a 14th age group student is doing the things which is for 15th age group students, then you can say the mental age of that child is 15. And many a time this is also possible, that the biological or the chronological age is 14, but the child is not able to perform, able to do the things which is kept for 14 age group students, which is meant for the 14 age group students. Okay. So that's why he or she is able to do the things which is for, let 12 age group students, 13 age group students. It means your mental age is less than the chronological age. Then accordingly, by using certain tests, you have to find out the mental age of the child. Then after getting the mental age, then what you have to do? MA upon CA into 100. Mental age divided by chronological age into 100. Let mental age is 15, chronological age is 14. So 15 by 14, 15 upon 14 into 100. So accordingly, you have to find out the IQ of the child. Okay. So you have to develop a test of intelligence, and after developing the test, you can also try out that test, and you can also use that test for knowing the IQ level of the students. Further, let us go forward. We have now, up to this, we have discussed about certain tools, certain tests, then further we will discuss about tools. I have already said that we use tests for measuring, for assessing, for knowing the scholastic abilities of the learners. And we use different tools for measuring the core scholastic abilities of the learners. So friends, let us now focus upon how to measure these core scholastic abilities by using different tools. Here you see on your screen, the first tool is rating scale. Okay, so try to understand that what is a rating scale. So friends, let me to say that for measuring attitude of the learners, of the teachers, or of any subject, you can say maybe for parents, we can use a rating scale. So rating scale is a tool that can be used for measuring attitude. Okay, so what is the attitude of the students? So we can say that now NEP 2020, that has been implemented across the country. Okay, that is in the process of implementation across the country. So what is the attitude of the teachers towards this NEP 2020? Okay, you can take any section, like school education section, school education part of NEP 2020. So the particularly, if I will tell that the new pedagogical structure, 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4 system of education, 5 years of foundational stage, 3 years of preparatory stage, then again 3 years of middle stage, then 4 years of secondary stage. Okay. So here, what is the attitude of teachers towards this new structure, pedagogical structure of school education? Okay. So you can also take the attitude of the teachers by using certain rating scale. So friends, let us try to understand that what is the concept of a rating scale. Rating scale is used to assess attitude of the students on any situation on any idea, object, character, person, or an attribute. Try to understand. Rating scale is used to know attitude of the students or teachers or any subject on a situation. Let there is a situation. So about that situation, you can ask, what is your attitude towards this situation? What is your attitude towards an idea? Many a time you will find that your school is coming forward with an idea that how to manage teaching learning process during this COVID time, okay, during this corona time. Many schools, almost all the schools, you will find that they are dealing the students online by using in Google platform, Google Meet platform, and other online learning platform also. So what is your idea? What is the idea of the school? How to do the assessment? How to do the subjective assessment of the students? Or whether the school will do only the objective assessment? And how to bring control upon this assessment? So upon this idea of the school, you can also give your attitude. One's attitude can be measured upon any idea, upon any object, okay? Then upon any character, upon any person, I can ask you your attitude towards your colleagues. I can ask a student that his or her attitude towards their friends. Okay, so attitude can be measured by using rating scale, or person, or an attribute. Okay, attribute means the personality of a person, the attitude in a person. Your attitude towards a person about his or her thinking process, about his or her opinion, about his or her perception, that can also be done. Then rating scale measure an attitude or an attribute or attitude in different scale points, that is 3, 5, or 7. So friends, in a rating scale, we measure attitude, and here there is no right answer or wrong answer. But in a quantum of response, in a degrees of response, what you can do, you can just give your response. That may be in a 3-point scale, or may be in a 5-point scale, or in a 7-point scale. But in the teaching learning process, in our school process, in research also, mostly we use a 7-point rating scale. That's called a Likert type of rating scale. I'm just giving two examples, friends. The first example is, item can be positive or negative. I have already said that item can be positive or negative. Okay, the statement or the questions that you have mentioned, that you have taken for measuring attitude of the students, that can be a positive statement or can also be a negative statement. I will give certain example. And this is a 5-point scale. You see, the first is very effective, second is moderately effective, third is average, fourth is moderately effective, moderately ineffective, and fifth is very ineffective. You see the description. Okay. This is started from very effective to very ineffective, and in the middle, that is average. So accordingly, we can use rating scale. I'm just giving another example, that semester system of education encourages learners to engage in their studies regularly. Okay, so in a semester system, we engage learners in their studies regularly. Whether you are strongly agree or simply agree or undecided, that you are not in a point to take a decision, then further, whether you are disagree or you are strongly disagree. Okay, so keeping in consideration of your response, a score will be given. Then accordingly, keeping in consideration of total item of this rating scale, then you will get a score. Okay, so that score will exhibit, that score will show that what type of attitude you are having. So for measuring, for knowing attitude, we can use the attitude scale. Then further, we can use questionnaire. Okay, questionnaire is a device comprising a series of questions dealing with some psychological, educational, and social issues, that it can be closed and open-ended also. Okay, so when you have closed the questions, it means you are not giving any any options. Okay, so we can say that is a closed question. And when we are closed question means when you are giving options, and when you are not giving options, you can say that is open question. I'm just giving two examples. You see, example of open question, that is describe any verb of the wars fought for independence in India. So you have to describe any war. I am not particularly name any war. So it is up to you. Second, for example, write an essay on Quit India Movement. You have to write an essay on Quit India Movement. Okay, so it is up to you that what are the things you have to write. Then further, let me to give another example of closed-ended question here. Just like in which year Quit India Movement took place. This is the question. And multiple options, I have given four options. 1941, 1942, 1943, and 1944. So when you are writing a questionnaire, you can take two types of questions, open questions and closed questions. Then inventories. Inventories are just like questionnaire, mostly used for measuring personality, interest, values, adjustment, etc. Responses are given in the inventories are like yes or no, agree or disagree. So here you have to give a response, either yes or no, or agree or disagree. Just like example, I think I am completely more tense than others. So whether you are agree or disagree in this, or whether you are saying yes or no. Then second, do you think you are more tense than other person around you? Do you think such things? So that's why you are agree or disagree. So in an inventory, you will find such types of questions are given, and you have to select either agree or disagree, or yes or no. Further, let us come to checklist. A checklist is a simple device consisting of a prepared list of items on any relevant problems. Okay, just like, is the school building fireproof? Yes or no? You have to check it and put a T. You have to visit the school and you have to see whether this school is having a fireproof equipment or not, fireproof system or not. If it is there, then put a tick mark on yes. If it is not there, put a tick mark on no. Then second, does this school follow rain harvesting policy? Yes or no. Is the school building earthquake proof? Yes or no. So such type of keeping in consideration of the issue, the problem, you can develop a checklist. Then you have to observe the things, then put either yes or no in every item. Then further, interview. Interview is an interaction between the interviewer and the interviewee on any issue or problem. So it is an interaction between an interviewer and an interviewee. Direct interaction, face-to-face interaction. And certain gadgets, certain electronics gadgets can also be used for conducting interview. Telephone interview can be conducted. Video interview can be conducted through video teleconferencing. Okay. Then further, it can be structured or unstructured. Structured means already you have written the items, the questions. Okay. And questions is there. With the question, certain option is also there. So, the subjects or the interviewee will choose any option, that option you will take. And in unstructured interview, only questions will be given and freedom will be given to the rest. To the interviewee to provide their responses. So a structured or an unstructured interview can also be used. Further, observation. Observation schedule are the enumeration, listing of the facts or other data that are observed under observation process. It can also be structured and unstructured. Friends, I have already said that observation is one of the very important tool so far as teaching learning process is concerned. Okay. So far as constructivist approach of teaching and learning process is concerned, so far as assessment for learning is concerned, so observation should well used by the teacher for assessing the performance of the learners, not only for scholastic abilities, but for co-scholastic abilities also. So mostly this is used for co-scholastic abilities. Then further, we can say the anecdotal record. So you will find that in a school, They have developed a system, a record. You'll find that the data of the students are cumulatively kept, okay, to know the performance of the learners, the abilities of the learners in different aspect, in age-wise and class-wise. Okay, the data, the academic data and other data of the students in class 3, class 4, class 5, things. What is the growth of the students from one stage to another stage, from one class to another class? from one edge stage to another edge stage. So that can also be developed then further portfolio. You see, portfolio consists of a type of record of creative work of the students over a period of time. So nowadays you will find that CBSE has made it compulsory for implementing portfolio and rubrics. So here what you have to do, you might be doing it and your school might be practicing it. So you see, many activities students do over the times, okay, in the school, in a particular standard, in different subjects. So what they will do, they have to preserve the activities in terms of reports that they have performed, okay. And within a period of time, maybe in first semester, that can also be used as one of the assessment tool. Means what they have recorded, what the activities that they have recorded, the concerned teacher, the observer, they will go through it, the coordinator will go through it and provide a grade to the learner. So that's why portfolio can also be used as a tool. So nowadays you will find that many schools, they have implemented e-portfolio. Okay, so that portfolio can be preserved in different account in a computer. Okay, so that can be done electronically also. Then further, the important thing what I am now discussing, that is the blueprint of a test. You have to do it today afternoon in the test. You have to do it in a test. So that is, you see, you have to develop a blueprint. A blueprint is called as a three-dimensional chart where weightage is given to content, objectives, and forms of questions in terms of marks. Okay. So in a blueprint, three dimension are there. Content is one dimension, objective is another dimension, and forms of question in terms of mark is the third dimension. As an example, you see a test, a blueprint of a test, an achievement test of social science for class 9. Here you see total mark is 100, total item is 100, and each item carries one mark. Type of items, that is objective types of items, means all items are multiple choice types of item, and weightage to objective, that is knowledge type of question 40%, understanding 20%, application 20%, skill types of question is 20% as per the Bloom's taxonomy. Okay, I am not going detail about because it takes time. I have to take another 5 minutes and I will complete it. Then weightage to content, here 25% each from history, political science, economics and civics, means 25% questions and weightage, 25% weightage of question and weightage of marks to be given to four subject areas in social science, because this is an achievement test of social science for class 9. Here you see on your screen, you might be watching now blueprint or table of specification. Here you see in the first column, subject is there, history, political science, economics and civics. Four subjects have been taken for an achievement test of social science. And in the second column, you will find that the questions from knowledge areas, question from third column, that is understanding area, then application and area and skill area. So as per the weightage, this has been calculated that you have to take 10 questions from knowledge area for history, 5 questions from understanding area, 5 questions from application, 5 questions from skill, and total will be 25. Okay. Again, in political science, weightage, political science, weightage is 25%. Okay. 10 questions from knowledge, 5 questions from understanding, 5 questions from application, 5 questions from skill. Accordingly, if you add all the knowledge type of question of 4 different subjects, that is 40. We have given 40% to knowledge, then 20% to understanding, 20% to application, 20% to skill. And if you add subject-wise weightage, that is 25% each to different subjects. So what you have to do, you have to prepare a blueprint first, okay? Maybe for 40 questions or for 50 questions on any subject, then you have to submit it, you have to submit it at your study center. Here you see, each individual learner or within the small group, if you are in a study center. If you are not in a study center, then you have to do it individually. And if you are in a study center, and if you want to do it in a small group, especially in Jammu and Kashmir, I got an impression that they are in study center, they can group within small group. We'll develop one test or two. Individual learner or in group will select certain chapter from the subject of their choice, prepare a blueprint and write the items As per the blueprint for the test, this will be followed by presentation of the tool or test items by each group at the afternoon session and submission of the tool at the study center. While making presentation, individual learner or group will explain the process of tool development along with the objectives and its dimensions. Feedback and suggestions will be provided by the resource person and other participants, and evaluation will be done. So friends, what you have to do? First of all, you have to develop that what tool or what test you have to develop, from which subject, and you have to identify certain components, certain chapter. Let you have to develop from 4 chapter on a subject. Then how many, what weightage you will be given to different questions. Okay, knowledge, understanding, application and skill. Okay, what weightage to give to different chapter. Then accordingly you have to prepare the blueprint. Then as per the blueprint, you have to write the items. Okay, whether multiple choice types of question, true and false types of question, okay, yes or no types of questions, it is up to you. Okay, so you have to develop the blueprint. Accordingly, you have to write the items and you have to submit the blueprint with the test or the tool at your study center. And at the afternoon, what you have to do, you have to present your blueprint with the test within the group in your study center. Your resource person will go through it and accordingly you will get the feedback. So this is today's activity. So friends, I have completed first session, that is why assessment, and in the second session, how assessment. Now it is up to you. Again, you have to conceptualize it. In Facebook video recording is there. Again, anytime you can go through it, and you have to do it and do the activities today afternoon at your study center as per your schedule. Thank you. This much from my side. Thank you. All the best to all our learners who are participating this 10 days B.Ed. second year workshop. Thank you. Thank you.